I definitely want to talk to it first.
I'm not deciding one way or the other until I know what we've got here. I want to start it up, interrogate it.
If we activate it, there is no guarantee we can deactivate it again.
Bullets can.
That's not what I...
Thank you, both of you, for your recommendations. I've made my decision.
Tali's gonna freak when she hears about this.
Tali was with us. We brought it.
So what about this Reaper IFF?
I have determined how to integrate it with our systems. However, the device is Reaper technology. Linking it with the Normandy's systems poses certain risks.
Well, just be careful then.
I trust you, Edie. I know you won't let anything happen to the ship.
Understood, Shepard. It may take several hours before the IFF is ready for shakedown. I will alert you as soon as it is ready.
Sounds good. Till then, it's business as usual. Crew dismissed.
Dismissed. Friend or foe? Okay, so we got plus 5 Renegade, plus 22 Paragon. We got research for this. And that. Await IFF installation. Complete recruitment and end 7 missions while the Normandy crew installs the Reaper IFF. Okay, hold on one moment. Okay. So. I guess we'll do a crew update. Thought the doors weren't gonna open. See if anyone has anything new to say. Yeah, the upgrades are in the other room.
Commander, can I help you with something?
Thoughts on the mission? Anything new?
How we doing, Jacob? What's your sense of the mission?
We installed the IFF and we're good to go. As long as we're ready for where we're going. The chance of coming back is... small. Anything else, Commander?
Opinion of the crew?
What do you think of the state of the crew?
This crew is as good as it can be. We've got a shot. A long shot. But it's a hell of a lot better than nothing. Anything else, Commander?
I don't know if that's what he said before or not.
I understand you made quite an impact after you left the Alliance.
Like I said, it was where I met Miranda and got scouted by Cerberus. It took us out to the Nemean Abyss and back. Saved the Citadel from a Batarian bioweapon. The whole thing was hushed like they're good at doing. But I know what I did, and I'm proud of it.
Just peeking in here?
I'm more interested in just talking for a bit.
If you want, Commander. Cerberus has ranks, but it's not the Alliance. No rules about fraternization. Your boat, your call. You want to get friendly with everyone? That's your business.
This is friends. You don't want to be friends?
You sound hesitant, Jacob. Am I putting you on the spot?
You're trying to. Sorry if I knee-jerked. Cerberus puts a lot of suspicion in your head. I like you, Shepard. So talk. And we'll see how it goes.
You okay about your father?
You want to talk about what happened with your father?
I don't really have anything to say about that, Commander. It's done with.
But besides him, any family?
Anyone waiting for you back home?
Only child and no extended family. Never settled down. Didn't seem fair with this job. But you can't miss what you never had.
Not gonna ask him that. You and Miranda have history?
I know you and Miranda work together. I got the impression it might have been more than that.
It got a little close. Then it got really far apart. The rest isn't your business, Commander.
Definitely not choosing this. And that's rude, so let's drop it.
Consider it dropped. I trust you to keep everything professional, Jacob.
Thanks. That always bugged me about the Alliance. They didn't let people handle their own problems. Cerberus isn't any better. They just put more effort into hiding how much they spy on you.
None. I don't want to give them a show. We have nothing to hide.
Let them watch. We're not hiding anything.
Wouldn't matter if we were. It's not like they can reel us in. We're handling this, whether they like it or not. Anyway, I should get back to prep. Nice talking to you, Shepard. Let's do it again sometime.
Okay. Yeah, I'd wasn't sure what that meant, giving them a show, so I'm not choosing that. No show here. It's not that kind. Let's just do our upgrades. We'll talk to Mordin. Okay, we'll have an upgrade for sniper rifles. Scram Pulsar. I can't use them, but someone else can. Prototypes, alright, the skin weave, 5 out of 5. Only 10,000 palladium required out of 113,000. Shepherd gets plus 50% health. Hell yeah! We are healthy as anything now. Hello, Mr. Mordin.
Shepherd, how can I help?
Squad status.
Are there any medical concerns I should be aware of on the team?
Cerberus personnel in excellent condition. No squad concerns to report. Always some matters, but nothing affecting immediate mission.
Lab setup.
Is the lab working well for you?
Quite satisfactory. Found a few surveillance bugs. Destroyed most of them. Returned expensive one to Miranda. Nothing unexpected. Just need more samples. More collector data, tissue samples, anything you can get, I can use. Find new tech.
I think those are the responses he gave before. I'm gonna venture in here again.
Have you got a minute to talk?
Yes. Good timing, in fact. Excellent. Made breakthrough. Can share results while next samples grow.
Are you smiling?
Keep waiting for culture analysis. Never fast enough. Usually no result in advance. Just checking work. Have to be careful. Getting on track. Discovery. Based on Prothean collector connection, can examine technology, chart Reaper species modification, fall of Protheans.
How does that help us?
Does knowing how the Protheans fell tell us anything useful about how to stop the Collectors or the Reapers?
Not yet. More useful as motivation. Effects on Protheans more than indoctrination, body modification. No self-preservation instinct. Old injuries not healed, no reproduction, just cloning. Technology overriding biology, not augmenting. No art, no culture. Closer to husks than slaves. Tools for Reapers. Protheans dead. Collectors just final insult. Must be destroyed.
Hmm. What's your motivation in all this?
I didn't think you needed any more motivation than you already had to stop the Collectors.
Enjoyed challenge. Saw necessity of attack on Collectors after plague on Omega. Their work, my people. Hard to care about two armies. One wins, one loses. Always work to do after. Now, have more context. See what Collectors are. Hmm. Wasn't looking for other work before. Don't mean to imply that. Just committed now. Won't let you down.
Well, I definitely trust Mordin not to let us down. Anger about modification.
What is it about the Collector's modifications that bothers you so much?
Disrupts socio-technological balance. All scientific advancement due to intelligence overcoming, compensating for limitations. Can't carry a load, so invent wheel. Can't catch food, so invent spear. Limitations. No limitations, no advancement. No advancement, culture stagnates. Works other way, too. Advancement before culture is ready. Disastrous. Saw it with Krogan. Uplifted by Salarians. Disastrous. Our fault.
Your fault?
You blame the Salarians for what the Krogan did?
Yes. Like giving nuclear weapons to cavemen. Krogan unprepared for spaceflight, technological advance. Krogan could have evolved alone, worked out aggression, been ready to use new tech responsibly. Instead, Salarians came, disrupted Krogan culture, used Krogan as blunt instrument against Rachni.
Huh.
Short-sighted. Foolish.
You know, I don't know if they've explicitly stated, or I just, if they haven't specifically stated, or I just wasn't aware and totally glazed over the fact that the Krogan were not a spacefaring race when the Salarians found them. That I was not completely aware of. Huh. But you re-sterilized them.
If you feel that way, why did you work on the genophage modification?
Talked before. Best option. That, or kill them all. If around during first contact, would have argued against it. Wasn't there then. Do what I can.
Hmm. Yeah, because I was kind of wondering how they... Excuse me. I was kind of wondering how they got the space flight, because there's not a lot of Krogan scientists. And they're even more bestial than Klingons. Interest in art?
You said the collectors had no art. I had no idea you cared about that kind of thing.
Personal interest negligible. Sang a little. Multi-species productions for cultural exploration. Gilbert and Sullivan always had me do the patter songs. But not about me. Cultural artistic expression reflects philosophical evolution, interest in growth, perspective, observation, interpretation.
Right.
Suspect you won't see any art in collector base.
No.
Culturally dead. Tools for reapers. Worse than the Geth.
Right. Well, you sang?
I'm sorry, I know that was important, but you performed Gilbert and Sullivan?
I am the very model of a scientist Salarian. I studied species Turian, Asari, and Batarian. I'm quite good at genetics as a subset of biology because I am an expert, which I know is a tautology. My xenoscience studies range from urban to agrarian. I am the very model of a scientist Salarian.
That was awesome. That was freaking awesome. Sorry, guys. Getting loud. Yeah. And immediately thinking back to Babylon 5, Marcus Cole, if I have it right. I know his name is Marcus, the ranger. He sang the song. He sang it very quickly. But yeah, it drove poor Dr. Franklin crazy. These guys are obviously Babylon 5 fans. I'm playing it again.
I'm sorry, I know that was important, but
I am the very model of a scientist Salarian. I've studied species Turian, Asari, and Batarian. I'm quite good at genetics as a subset of biology because I am an expert, which I know is a tautology. My xenoscience studies range from urban to agrarian. I am the very model of a scientist Salarian.
That is genius, the way they changed those lines. And so well done. That's awesome. Okay. I don't have anything else to say.
Thanks for sharing what you've learned, Mordin.
Proud to be here, Shepard. Thank you for including me.
Keep up the great work. Great singing. I love that. Gotta say, that's my favorite Mordin moment. Favorite Mordin moment. Oh, Kelly.
We have a Geth down in the AI core. It makes me a little uneasy. I hope you don't activate him. You would know best.
How's the crew?
Is there anything I should know?
You have unread messages at your private terminal. Anything else, Commander?
That's not about the crew.
Do you have a moment to talk?
I always have time for you, Commander.
What do you think of Cerberus? See if she gives any more different lines.
This organization has a dark reputation. Do you have any concerns working for them?
Not at all. Our methods can be harsh, but Cerberus has noble objectives. We look out for human interests. Advance human technology, save human lives. They're good goals.
Does Cerberus hate aliens?
It sounds like Cerberus wants to dominate all aliens and put humankind on top.
Cerberus looks out for humanity, but that doesn't mean we hate aliens. My sister started a dog shelter, but she loved cats too.
Huh.
I love humanity. I also love Asari, Quarian, Turian, Salarian, Hanar.
Sorry,
that isn't in conflict with Cerberus ideals.
You're very loving.
That's a very positive attitude.
What can I say? I'm a people person. Anything else you'd like to talk about?
What do you do?
What are your responsibilities?
Silly to
I'll
ask.
I'll keep you notified of any messages or appointments you might have. If any of the crew has important business to discuss, I'll make sure you know.
Is that all?
Isn't that the type of task better suited for a VI?
Yes, but being your yeoman is just my official role. Unofficially, I observe the crew. Everyone knows how risky our mission is. Many of us may not be coming back. That's a lot of pressure. I have a degree in psychology. I'm good at sensing when people are overly taxed.
Okay. Are you happy here?
How do you feel about being assigned to the Normandy?
I was handpicked by the Elusive Man to help fight the greatest threat known to humanity. How do I feel? Honored, exhilarated, terrified. But mostly I feel encouraged. Under your leadership, we can't fail.
Don't really believe that, but I'll play the cocky commander. We won't.
Don't worry. We'll defeat the collectors.
I trust you implicitly. The moment I met you, I knew I could close my eyes, fall back, and you'd be there.
Tempted. I'd catch you.
Your trust is well placed, Kelly.
I knew it would be. Thank you, Shepard. Anything else you'd like to talk about?
Nope.
I better go.
Okay. Maybe we'll talk with...
The IFF is nearly installed, Shepard. However, I must test its impact on the Normandy systems. I suggest you take the shuttle to access your next location.
Okay.
What's this area of the ship?
This is the Combat Information Center. Here, the crew receives sensor data and coordinates gunnery and damage control efforts.
Back from female camp, from Erdnot Dark. Dear human, the clan leader told me how to get in touch with you. I don't remember much of what happened, but the chief scout says you pulled my quad out of the fire when I got caught and poisoned over at the Werelog camp. Now, from what I gather, his quad is his testicles, of which there are four. Thanks. Next time I have a chance to kill a human, I won't. Unless I go into blood rage or something. Hey, well, you know, everyone can understand that. I got to go to the female camp after I recovered, and it was pretty good. I was actually thinking of joining the Blood Pack before this happened. I think I'm going to stay here instead. Erdnot Darg Scout, 2nd Class. Encrypted transmission from Elusive Man. Shepard, I am pleased that you were able to recover the Reaper IFF, and I've sent Edie all the necessary protocols to get it integrated successfully into the Normandy systems. With luck, this will give us the ability to get through the Omega-4 relay and take the fight to the Collectors on our own terms. I've been notified about the intact Geth and your decision to keep it. If you believe that it can be trusted, then go ahead and activate it. Just make sure that Edie is adequately protected against any hacking attempts. I don't know if it can be trusted, but I am going to activate it. Unless it's already activated. I don't know. It's not necessarily the decision I would have made, Shepard, but this is your call. You've already cast a wide net in your recruiting efforts, and if the Geth are willing to fight the Collectors, then we can use them on the team. I trust you to get the job done, whatever it takes. So apparently this is our 7 of 9 or something that we have here. Have it done. It's been,
While Normandy is flown from the bridge, during combat, the commanding officer issues orders from the CIC.
Oh, she's continuing to say that. I thought you would say something. I thought I had conversation options. Well, I can talk to her here. Joker!
Commander.
How are things in the cockpit?
I assume everything's going well up here?
Good for now. Fractured my thumb on the mute, but I think I made my point.
Same thing you said last time. What do you think about the mission?
So, how do you think we're doing?
Well, the Normandy's good. Everything's upgraded and better than ever. If we're talking about the crew, you'd probably have to ask a people person.
I just talked to a people person back there. The squad.
What do you think about the people we're picking up?
Well, about the ones you went out with last. Samara feels like she could shoot me in a very tranquil way, which does not make me feel any better about it. Well, I always liked Tali, so let's just move on. It's just my opinion, though. There's really no need to go spreading around.
Well, that's interesting. So every time I go out with somebody else, I can ask him about the squad that I just went with. I'll have to keep that in mind. I did not know that. Good old days.
Ever think about the old Normandy and the trouble we got up to?
Yeah, those seem like the good old days now, but come on, it was hell at the time. Geth, Saren, Sovereign, and then we got dumped. We're stuck in a weird place, sure, but back then it wasn't all sunshine and bunnies.
What about the old crew?
What happened to the rest of the old crew? I heard most survived.
Almost did. Presley didn't.
Yeah.
The rest of us just sort of drifted apart.
So sad,
Presley.
Alliance
didn't care. I don't think they liked all the non-humans in your crew. We were your team, Commander. With the Normandy destroyed and you gone, there wasn't much keeping us together.
Yeah, I understand.
That's it for now.
See you, Commander.
The crew is still working to get the Reaper IFF installed, Shepard. It is more complicated than I first anticipated. I will alert you once the system is ready for shakedown. Is there anything else I can do for you?
I want to know more about you.
Do you have a specific inquiry?
You and Joker.
How are you getting along with Joker?
Mr. Moreau does not trust me. It offends him that I am installed aboard his ship's computers.
Yeah, the last Normandy did just fine without an AI reminding me the airlock is ajar.
Why are you named Edie?
Edie is the phonetic pronunciation of E-D-I. That is an acronym for Enhanced Defense Intelligence.
Location? Well, the core is by the medical bay.
Where are you?
My core intelligence is housed in a quantum blue box located behind the medical bay.
Blue boxing.
What do you do aboard the ship?
I operate the ship's electronic and cyber warfare suites in combat. My reaction time is much faster than any organic.
Yeah.
I collate the records of shipboard monitoring devices for the elusive man. I have also gained access to anti-Reaper cyber warfare algorithms recovered by Cerberus.
Anti-Reaper algorithms?
The Reapers are millions of years more advanced than us. How can you affect them?
It appears that my design includes hardware recovered from the wreckage of Sovereign. These systems contain cyber warfare attack programs of considerable sophistication. I have allocated most of my processing power to analyzing them.
If this thing starts claiming to be the vanguard of our destruction, then I got shotgun on the first lifeboat, okay?
And cyber warfare?
Cyber warfare means things like viruses, right?
In close-range ship-to-ship combat, I can sometimes break through the firewalls of an enemy's internal wireless network.
Once I
seize control of their systems, I can turn off gravity or air. I can disable weapons guidance or shields, or I can put their fusion plant in meltdown. On the defense, I manage Normandy's own suite of jammers, decoys, and internal firewalls.
Our good friend Mr. Moreau is completely distracted while we're talking to Edie here. What monitoring devices?
The elusive man has monitoring devices on board?
He has invested most of Cerberus's resources into the design and construction of this ship. He has an interest in monitoring our progress.
Hmm.
Let's discuss something else.
Ready.
I don't need to know what this room is.
I want to know more about the people I'm working with.
Much of that data is classified. Do you have a specific inquiry?
Structure of Cerberus?
How is Cerberus organized? Aside from the elusive man, I don't see much chain of command.
Cerberus is organized into task-oriented cells. Each operates in isolation. Members from one cell cannot recognize the members of another. Each cell's agents are led by a single operator. We are called the Lazarus Cell, which is directed by Operator Lawson.
Hmm. How many cells are there?
So how many operations is Cerberus running right now?
I have a block that prevents me from answering that question.
A block?
What do you mean?
Although I am less controlled than other AI, I am still subject to behavioral blocks and the physical isolation of my hardware. In this case, I am prevented from truthfully answering your question by Cerberus's levels of secret classification.
Hmm. So basically, Edie has probably said all this stuff already, but, just in case anything's changed, I'm going through it, and it's been so long since I talked to Edie. It's not like you guys just heard this yesterday or something. Probably not, anyway. Building the Normandy.
How did Cerberus replicate the most advanced warship in the Alliance Navy without anyone knowing?
I have a block that prevents me from answering that question.
Oh my, resources.
What sort of resources does Cerberus have?
Block.
Money, personnel, facilities.
I have a block that prevents me from answering that question.
We have to remove these blocks.
That's all for now.
Logging you out, Shepard.
Hmm. Logging you out, too. Let me see if they say anything to each other. So I'm done with this floor completely. So I'll probably check in with our Geth friend last. It's just so I know if you leave these two alone, they start saying things. Look at these things on either side. There and there. They look like side mirrors. We're like a car. Objects may be closer than they appear. Or objects are closer than they appear. Whatever. They're not saying anything. So yeah, Legion. That seems to be that last space in our squad. You know, we pick out our squad. There's one space open. I've been wondering about that for like over a month. So that must be where Legion goes. Probably. I don't know if I have to run away and come back. But I'm getting bored. We've already heard some conversation, so let's go. We'll head down to engineering first. Actually, I'll head to my cabin. Just for the hell of it. One of my favorite, if not my very favorite theme from the first game. Sometimes I check to see if we have new items. That's been there. Unfortunately, I still have to get more fish. I'm not sure if I can get more fish. Engineering.
So, Gabby, what do you think of our new quarian boss?
Hush, she's right over there.
Ah, she can't hear us with her head in that bucket. Don't get me wrong,
can hear you.
It's a beautiful bucket. The whole suit is lovely, quite snug in all the right places.
You know I can hear you.
Of course she can hear you.
What can we do for you, Commander?
That's funny.
How did you wind up with Cerberus, Ken?
Once you were gone, the Alliance brass descended like vultures, tearing apart everything you'd said. I was very public with my defense for you. I didn't hold back.
Oh, thank
you. That's an understatement. If Kenneth wasn't such a talented engineer, they'd have court-martialed him for insubordination.
But it got me noticed by the elusive man. He made an offer, and here I am.
Pretty sure this is all the same.
So why did you join, Gabby?
Kenneth and I have been partners in crime since we graduated from Tech Academy. When he got the Cerberus offer, I insisted that it include me. He'd fall apart without me.
Thanks, Mom.
Also, I love engines, and the Normandy is state-of-the-art. When I got the opportunity to work on her, I had to jump.
She is cute as all hell, isn't she? Your training?
Where'd you receive your training?
Both Gabby and I started in the Alliance, serving on the SSV Perugia.
She flew in the first wave at the Battle of the Citadel. We saw Sovereign firsthand.
But you left the Alliance?
Why did you leave the Perugia?
After you died, Anderson lost political clout. The Council backslid on the Reaper menace.
They discounted Sovereign as an isolated threat, as a single...
Which was bullshit. They said your warnings of a greater danger were mistaken or delusional.
We lost respect for Alliance leadership. We need to fight the real enemy, and only Cerberus seemed to be doing that.
Sorry guys, I'm like sneezing and stuff. What are your feelings about Cerberus?
What do you think about Cerberus?
Actually, we don't know much about the organization other than the Normandy team. We know our mission and who's in charge.
We're off to kick the collectors right in their daddy bags. That's enough for me.
We're off to find the wizard. The wonderful wizard of... daddy bags. Daddy bags. I've actually never heard that term. And that's it.
Carry on.
Will do, Commander.
Hold on, guys. Okay. Suffice to say, I'm having technical difficulties with my body. Tali!
Shepard, what can I do for you?
I didn't scare you. Your work?
Is the new Normandy giving you any trouble?
Please, Shepard, I'm a quarian. Give me a chunk of scrap metal, a circuit board, and some element zero, and I'll have it making precision jumps. Mm-hmm. I was worried about working with Cerberus engineers, but they know what they're doing, and they've been very polite.
Good. Except for talking about you and thinking that you can't hear them, huh? Status of the Normandy.
How's the Normandy running?
Say what you will about Cerberus. They know how to build ships. The Normandy's running even better than before. I don't know if it can stand up to a collector attack, though. I'm researching some ideas that might help.
Okay, I want to talk about you.
Have you got time to talk?
Sure. Let me just... Come on, you little Boshtet! Oh, sorry.
Boshtet?
I've got a small fever, and I'm taking it out on the port drive core. No. Don't worry, it's nothing serious. Got sloppy while doing some suit repair.
Why did you get sick?
I never understood how you get sick from non-Quarian germs.
We don't, really. Turian germs are the only ones with any chance of affecting us, since we share amino acid chirality with them. What we experience is actually an acute allergic reaction.
Suited life sounds difficult.
I don't know if I could live inside a suit my whole life.
We are in our suits even among family. The most intimate thing we can do with another Quarian is link our suit environments. We get sick at first, and then we adapt. It's our most important gesture of trust, of acceptance. I haven't trusted anyone enough for that, though. Except... well, no Quarians. You know what I mean.
Sorry, guys. You're embarrassed?
Wait. I can't tell under the helmet. Are you blushing?
What? No! It's the fever! Last time I tried to pay a compliment to my Boshtet captain, I took the ship name and everything. I'm going to tinker a bit more. Thanks for coming by.
She's so funny. I got Renegade. Yeah, I took the Renegade option there. Alright. So, let's go to these cargo holds. Grunt?
Shepard.
The squad.
What do you think about the crew?
Good bunch if they stay out of my way. Dead bunch if they don't.
Yeah, you said that.
Train them good if you want to take on collectors. Some of these aliens are too smooth.
Speaking of collectors...
Did O'Kear give you any imprints about the collectors?
You already know more than he did. O'Kear's is barely useful. If you fight them, hit them hard the first time.
And the mission?
What are your thoughts about our mission?
We'll push our enemies to the edge of space, then step on their fingers one at a time until the void takes them.
Just checking in. How are you doing?
I was just sitting here thinking. The picture, I'm finally starting to get it. There's
really?
A tank imprint, the battle at Canrum. A dead Turian, stripped. You don't see them out of their armor much. A Krogan boot on his head, and a claw hammer. It's under the brow plate, pulling it back, right?
Oh.
Eyes have gone black, and you see tension in the muscle. You can feel it ready to snap. I get it.
Maybe I need context. Canrum?
Canrum isn't ringing a bell.
Death of Shiagar, female warlord. Turians killed her so they were hunted down and made examples. Even if they won the war, it was the last push before the rebellions ended.
So why is that funny?
Maybe I had to be there, but I don't get the joke.
There's no joke. It's just great. It's a Turian and he's being torn apart for what they did. I felt nothing before, but now I get it. It was a good fight. The enemy was destroyed to punish them all and send a message. I get it. I hate Turians. I thought you'd be glad.
What about Garrus?
Don't start anything with Garrus. I won't have trouble on my ship.
What about?
I don't hate Garrus. I hate the Turians. Garrus is just one Turian, and he's your clan. No point in ripping his face off unless he turns on me.
Okay.
It's hate, but it's mine. O'Kear was blind, and he tried to make me the same. But thanks to you, I have a clan. I'm starting to see why I should care. Anyway, I'm still figuring where I fit, but it made me laugh. Nothing else really on my mind, Shepard.
Okie doke. So we got plus two, Renegade, and Paragon. Oh, I'm completely filled up with Paragon, look at that. Alright, so as far as this, I'm gonna go ahead and take this. Heavy energy drain or area energy? I'm gonna do heavy. It's not very often that I'm coming across multiple foes with shields who are like close by each other. So let's purchase that. Heavy. Done. And if I get any more, I guess I'm putting it into charge and cryo ammo. Which I barely use charge and I don't use cryo ammo at all, hardly. At all. Right, some lines from Zaeed.
Back for more?
Yep.
I've done a lot of crazy things, but I never tried to take on a thresher more on foot before. Standard operating procedure when you get a thresher more is run the hell away. Pick up sticks, move the hell out. Krogan don't know any better, I guess. Still, hell of a fight.
Krogan don't know any better.
Can't say I blame Taylor's pop. A man does what he has to do to survive. Ran
Seriously?
Up against the Batarian camp, not too different from that one. Job was to erase the whole thing from the map. Men, women, and the man in charge. Learned that day that despots are cowards. You show them you're in charge, not them, and they cry like little girls.
Well, at least I can kind of identify with that last part, or think that's cool or something. Not what you say, you can't blame them.
I should let you go. Talk more later, Shepard.
Right. Down to the last cruise quarters.